To show that derivative of this e raised to the power z naught t is equal to z naught e raised to the power z naught t. So here you can see the expression at the top of your screen, e raised to the power z naught t. On right hand side, there is a variable or expression is in the form of z, while on right hand side of your equation, you can see it is in x and y. So it means we will put the value of the complex number z naught, which is equal to x naught plus iota y naught, and then you can give this expression. Okay. So because we have to show that the derivative of e raised to the power z naught t is equal to z naught e raised to the power z naught t. By definition, you can see that we can easily find the derivative, but here we will convert in Euler form. So we will write e raised to the power z naught t. On next step, we will put the value of z naught, which is equal to x naught plus iota y naught. Here, then you will separate e raised to the power x naught into e raised to the power iota y naught. Here, e raised to the power x naught is a constant, so we will separate this, and the remaining portion is e raised to the power iota y naught t. So, by using the Euler's formula, we will convert this e raised to the power iota y naught t in the form of the trigonometric function cos y naught t plus iota sine y naught t. Here, you can see at the top of your screen. And then we will multiply this with e raised to the power x naught t, because it is just like constant. So then we will apply the derivative on the real and imaginary portion, and derivative is with respect to t. So here on real part, you can see that there is a two function in the product form, e raised to the power x naught t and cos y naught t. So we will take its derivative by using the formula u into v form, first function as it is, or integration of derivative of second plus derivative of first function and the product of the second function plus iota and the derivative of the imaginary portion. So after taking their derivatives, we will again separate them in real and imaginary portion. So the real part is x naught e raised to the power x naught t cos y naught t plus iota sine y naught t. Okay, we will separate x naught e raised to the power x naught t. Similarly, we will take this common iota y naught e raised to the power x naught t from other portion. It will again become a cos y naught t plus iota sine y naught t. Okay, so here you can see we will separate this cos y naught t plus iota sine y naught t, and the remaining portion will be x naught plus iota y naught e raised to the power x naught t. Now again we will convert it in the form of the exponent. So cos y naught t plus iota sine y naught t, you can write it e raised to the power iota y naught t by using the Euler's formula. Okay, so here you can see that there are two exponential function, and because the bases are same, so you can add their powers. So it will become e raised to the power x naught plus iota y naught t. And at the start of your question, we know that x naught plus iota y naught is equal to y naught. Just put this value, then you will get the right hand side of your question. Okay, here you can see this which you want to solve. Okay, here let's check this question. Let wt is equal to ut plus iota vt. It means that wt is a complex function, and ut is its real part, and vt is its imaginary portion. Okay, be the continuous complex valued function on the interval t is greater than equal to minus 1 and less than equal to a. So first part is, suppose that wt is even. If the function is even, we know that w minus t will be equal to wt. For each point t in the given interval, show that this integral minus a to a wt dt is equal to 2 0 to a wt dt. So let's check it if your function is even. Okay, since wt is equal to ut plus iota vt and your function is even, so w minus t is equal to u minus t plus iota v minus t. Okay, since function is even, so its real and imaginary portion will also be even. So u minus t is equal to ut and v minus t is equal to vt. So let's start we will take its integration minus a to a w t dt. So just put its formula ut plus iota vt, and then we will apply the integration on real and imaginary part separately. So you will write minus a to a ut dt plus iota minus a to a vt dt. So we will break this limit because we have to come this point 0 to a. Okay, so minus a to 0 ut dt plus 0 to a ut dt plus iota minus a to 0 vt dt plus iota 0 to a vt dt. Here we will come to this point. We will separate these in integration limits, minus a to 0 ut dt plus iota minus a to 0 vt dt. Similarly, we will separate the other limits 0 to a with real and imaginary portion. Okay. So we will put these values from first bracket. Here you can see minus a to 0. So it will become 0 to minus t. When it will become, when we will replace this t with minus t, so the limits will change. So it will become 0 to a plus iota 0 to a vt dt. And here we know that the function is even, so vt is equal to v minus t, so there will be no change. Okay, and the remaining portion will be same, integral 0 to a ut plus iota vt dt. Here your function is even, so the first portion is ut plus iota vt, so it will become wt, and the other portion is same, integral 0 to a wt wt dt. So when you will add these two integrals, you will get 2 integral 0 to a wt dt, which is the proof which you want to conclude. Okay, similarly you can solve this. When function is odd, the whole answer will be 0. So you should solve this. Solution is given here, you should do it yourself. Here exercise 4.2, question number 1, for the function f and contour c, from question number 1 to 6, use parametric representation for c or legs of c to evaluate integral. Here you can see this integral c is written in the subscript of your integral. This c stands for the contour integration. Okay, f of z dz, function is a given which is equal to f of z is equal to z plus 2 divided by z, and c is, so this is the pure complex integration, contour integration. We call this contour integration. In previous exercise 4.1, we discussed just simple integration, but here now we will discuss the complex integration or contour integration. Okay, so first of all you should know the formula of your contour integration. So here you can see at the top of your screen, you can see the formula integral c f of z dz, which is equal to integral a to b f of z theta into z dash theta d theta. This is the formula for your contour integration. So it means for contour integration, you should know the function first of all. Then you should know the its curve, whether it's a circle, semicircle, straight line, rectangular shape, whatever it is. So first of all, you should know the function. Then you should know the value of z. Then you will put the value in this formula, integral a to b f z theta into z dash theta d theta. So here in this question, the function is f of z, which is equal to z plus 2 divided by 2. Okay, and the curve c is in first portion a part. This call the curve is a semicircle z, which is equal to 2 e raised to the power iota theta. So here the function f of z and the curve z is given. So we will find this value. First of all, we will check the z theta. So z theta is equal to 2 e raised to the power iota theta. The next portion is we want its first derivative. So just take its first derivative z dash theta, which is equal to 2 iota e raised to the power iota theta. Now we will find the function f of z theta. Function is in this question is z plus 2 upon z. And z theta is equal to, what is the value of this? 2 e raised to the power iota theta. So just put here the value, we will get 1 plus 2 upon z theta. So z theta is equal to 2 e raised to the power iota theta. Just simplify, we will cancel this 2 in numerator and denominator. It will become f z theta is equal to 1 plus e raised to the power minus iota theta. So the limits move from, it is given in your question at the top of your screen, theta moves from 0 to pi. So it will become, when you will put these values, integral 0 to pi f of z theta. So we just calculate f of z theta, which is equal to 1 plus e raised to the power minus iota theta, and z dash theta, which you just find 2 iota e raised to the power iota theta. Just simplify this question, and then we will take its integration by using some appropriate formula and apply upper and lower limits. After simplification, here you can see cos e raised to the power iota pi, you will convert it cos pi plus iota sine pi. Just put these values and the answer will be, after simplification, minus 4 plus 2 pi iota. Okay, I hope you people can understand. Just try to solve this question, then we will move to next. Okay, exercise 4.2, question number 1. You should solve this question, then we will practice other questions from the contour integration. Okay, I will close this. You should check from your copy, which is uploaded here in Teams. Exercise 4.2, question number 1. You have 5 to 10 minutes to solve this question and send me. Okay. Okay, let's move to the next question. Here, the semicircle Z, second part, Z is equal to 2 e raised to the power iota theta. I think it is a similar question. We should solve some different one. Here, question number 2 on your screen, you can see f of z which is equal to z minus 1 and c curve is the arc from z0 to z equal to 2 consisting of first part semicircle. Okay, so here theta moves from pi to 2 pi. So we know that in contour integration we should know the function f of z which is equal to z minus 1 and the curve z which is equal to 1 plus e raised to the power iota theta. So z theta is equal to 1 plus e raised to the power iota theta. The next term is z dash theta because we want this in this formula. So z dash theta is equal to iota e raised to the power iota theta when you will take its derivative. Now the formula integral c f of z dz is equal to integral pi to 2 pi because the moment of theta is here pi to 2 pi f of z theta which is here is z minus 1. So z is equal to 1 plus e raised to the power iota theta minus 1 and z dash of theta was just calculated. Just put here these values. After simplification we will take its integration and just put the upper and lower limits, you will get the answer is 0. Okay, similarly the next part is here the function is same. F of z is equal to z minus 1 and just z, the curve z is equal to x, we will take its derivative, so it will become z dash of x which is equal to 1. Okay, just put this value and solve this after simplification and putting the upper and lower limits, you will get the answer 0. Here the question number 3 on your screen, you can see f of z is equal to pi exp means exponential pi z conjugate. Okay, so this is exp means exponential function. Okay, so your function is pi exponential pi z conjugate and c is the boundary of the square with vertices at point 0 1 1 plus iota and iota and the orientation of the curve c being in the counterclockwise direction. Okay, so first of all here you can see that we want to find the contour integration, but only you have it is given here f of z is given in this question, but they didn't discuss about the curve z, what will be the value of z. So here first of all we will find the value of z in this question, but how we will find that value, let's see, because you should know the keep in mind the formula of contour integration. That is integral a to b f of z theta into z dash of theta. So f of z is given in this question, which is equal to pi e raised to the power pi z conjugate, but z is missing. So first of all we will find this z. In this question they have given the vertices of the curve. Okay, and the vertices of curve is 0 1 1 plus iota and iota. So first of all we will see this number on your graph. Let's see, 0, it is a real number. When we will convert in the complex form you can write it 0 plus 0 iota. It means that it will be 0 because when we will convert 0 plus 0 iota in the form of order pair you can write 0 0, so it means it is origin. So we will start from origin 0 plus 0 iota. Here you can see on the graph the next point is 1. It means when you will write it in the complex number you can write 1 is equal to 1 plus 0 iota. It means when we will convert 1 plus 0 iota in the order pair form you can write 1 0. The value of x is 1 and the value of y is 0. Okay, so you can see this point c1 curve, along c1 curve 1 plus 0 iota. The next point is 1 plus 1 iota. So when you will convert it in order pair form, you can write this complex number 1 plus iota is equal to 1, 1. So it will become this coordinate C2 line, you can see 1, 1. where the value of x and y both values are 1. Okay, so the next is iota value. So when you will convert this iota in complete complex number, you can write it 0 plus iota. It means the value of x is 0 and the value of y is 1. So it will become this point in between C4 and C3. You can see 0 plus 1 iota. Okay. So the question in which the curve is not given. So first of all, you will find the curve by using these vertices point. So we have drawn these points 0, 1, 1 plus iota and iota on your graph. So there are four parts of your curve. First part is C1, second C2, then C3 and then C4. So it is your complete curves which we will integrate. This is your complete contour C, which is subdivided in C, C2, C3 and C4. And the movement is counterclockwise. Okay. So first of all, we will find the function along C1. Okay. For C1, this function is, it is a movement from 0 to 1. Okay. So we know that the Z is the complex number. So you can write Z is equal to X plus iota Y. Here along C1, the value of X is from 0 to 1. So we will write X and Y is 0. You can see that because the value of X is variation in value of X from 0 to 1. So we will write it X plus iota Y. The value of Y is 0 here. Okay. So just put 0. You will get Z of X is equal to X. Can you understand this point? मेरा ख्याल है आप सभी सो रहे हैं. ओके
यस.
अच्छा, ये सोने पे यस था या समझ आने पे यस था?
तो सर समझ आने पे.
अच्छा,
समझ आने पे.
ओके ओके. सो वी विल टेक इट्स डेरिवेटिव z डैश x व्हिच इज इक्वल टू 1. ओके, सो पुट दीस वैल्यूज इन दिस फंक्शन f ऑफ zx. सो इट विल बिकम पाई e रेज़ टू द पावर पाई Z conjugate. So here Z is equal to X, where X is a real number. When you will take its conjugate, it will again become a real number. Okay. So the integration, the limits of integration, because we are moving from 0 to 1. So that's why we put integral 0 to 1 F of ZX, Z dash of X. So F of ZX, we just calculated pi e raised to the power pi X, and derivative of ZX, which is equal to 1. Here just simplify this question by putting upper and lower limits, you will get your answer. So just the technique is to find the value of zx. Okay, there is some technique. So now we will move from the curve C2. Here you can see in graph C2 is moving from 10 to 11. Okay, so it means value of x is same, that is 1, but the value of y is moving from 0 to 1. So there is a variation in y. So let's see zy, next function for C2 on your screen. You can see zy is equal to 1 plus iota y. Because we know the formula for z is x plus iota y, but along the curve C2, you can see there is no movement along x. So the value of x is 1, that is a constant, plus iota y, because the value of y is changing. Okay, we will take its derivative z dash of y, which is equal to iota. Then we will find the f of zy, which is equal to pi e raised to the power pi z conjugate. Here z is equal to 1 plus iota y. Then we will take its conjugate. It will become e raised to the power pi 1 minus iota y. Just put these values in your formula for contour integration, f of zy, z dash y. Just put all these values and then simplify. Take their integration from 0 to 1, because value of y is moving from 0 to 1. Okay, and the whole integration is along dy. So just simplify these steps and you can easily calculate the answer, 2 e raised to the power pi. Now we will discuss the curve C3. So first of all, I will show the curve C3. C3 is moving from 11 to 01. Here you can see the value of Here you can see the value of x is changing from 1 to 0. Okay. The value of y is same. You can see 1. So along the curve C3, as we know the formula for the complex number x plus iota y, here you can see that the x is a, there is a variation in x from 1 to 0. So that's why we will write it in the form of variable, and the value of y is a constant 1. So you just put here plus iota into 1. Okay, take its derivative, you will get 1. Here, because the function is changing in x, so you will write zx. Okay, it is a function of x. So f of zx will be pi e raised to the power pi z conjugate. Just take its conjugate, put these values in your formula. Here you can see the limits of your integration. We will discuss here. Now the integration is 1 to 0 because, just see this graph, C3, it is moving from, its arrow is moving from 1 to 0. Okay, so that's why we will put this limit 1 to 0. Just simplify this integral and you can easily integrate and get this answer e raised to the power pi minus 1. Now we will discuss the curve C4. C4 is moving from 0, 1 to 0, 0. Okay. So this is your curve C4. It was moving from 0, 1 to 0, 0. It means the value of x is 0 and the value of y is varying from 1 to 0. So that's why I just put x equal to 0. And because y is in variation, so just put iota y. Okay, this is your function. Whole value of z is x plus iota y. X here, x is 0 and y is in variation form. Okay, just take its derivative. So we'll get iota f of z y. So it will become pi e raised to the power pi z conjugate. After taking its conjugate, it will become e raised to the power minus iota pi y. Just put these values in your formula, contour integration f of z y into z dash y dy. Here limits are moving from 1 to 0 because y is moving from 1 to 0. So just put these limits. After simplifying this integral, just put these upper and lower limits, you will get your answer. So we find contour C1 along C2 along C3 and along C4. So what will be your total contour integration? Just add all these curves along C1, C2, C3 and C4. When you will add all these, you will get this answer 4 into e raised to the power pi minus 1. Okay, can you people understand this question?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Here you can see question number 4 on your screen. F of z is defined by this equation. F of z is equal to 1 when y is less than 0 and f of z is equal to 4y when y is greater than 0. And C is the curve from z minus 1 minus iota to z 1 plus iota. Okay, along the curve y is equal to x cube. So here function is given and the curve, your curve is y is equal to x cube. As we know that the z is equal to x plus iota y and the value of y is given in this question. So just put y is equal to x cube, then take its derivative. So it will become 1 plus 3 iota x square. So f of z, overall the limit is varying from minus 1 to 1. Okay, here you can see is varying from minus 1 to 1. Okay, so but the function is discontinuous on this point 0, so we will break over integral minus 1 to 0 and then 0 to minus 1. Okay, the formula of contour integration f of zx z dash of x dx. So when you will discuss minus 1 to 0, it means it's less than 0. Okay, so we will put the value of function 1, and when we will discuss the limit 0 to 1, we will discuss this point 4x cube. The value of f of zx is 4x square. Just put these values and just simplify this question. You will get your answer. Can you understand this question? Ji samajh aa gaya ye question? Is question mein chuki ye continuous इसके डिफरेंट वैल्यूज थी फंक्शन की, मैंने इसलिए क्वेश्चन करवाया. आप ऐसा करें, यू शुड सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन, यू हैव 5 to 10 मिनट्स. ओके, सो बी क्विक. क्वेश्चन नंबर 4, यू कैन सी फ्रॉम योर नोट्स. ओके, Here you can see on your screen. Evaluate the integral I, integral z conjugate dz using this representation of C, where z is equal to square root 4 minus y square plus iota y. So here z is given, so find its derivative. F of z is equal to z conjugate, as it is mentioned in your question, integral z conjugate dz. Okay, so function is z conjugate. Put these values, apply the formula for contour integration, and then you can easily solve it. Okay, so you should do by yourself. Solution is attached here. So it was the second technique, contour integration. First of all, we discussed today the simple integration, then you will discuss the contour integration formula. So the next procedure for integration is antiderivative. It's just like a simple integration. Okay, so exercise 4.3 here on your screen, you can see use an antiderivative to show that for every contour C extending from a point Z to a point Z2, we will apply this formula. Integral Z raised to the power n is is equal to Z2 raised to the power n minus 1 minus Z1 raised to the power n minus 1 whole divided by n plus 1. Okay, so here you can see that was your question. So just take its simple integration, integral z raised to the power n dz, which is equal to z raised to the power, after taking its integration, n plus 1 divided by n plus 1, and just put the limits from z1 to z2, so you will get this answer. So next is, by finding an antiderivative, evaluate each of the integrals where the path is an arbitrary contour between the indicated limits of the integration. So here integral iota to iota by 2 e raised to the power pi z dz. Okay, just take it simple integration, e raised to the power pi z divided by pi, just put upper and lower limits, then you will, for solving purpose, you can shift these exponential in the form of the Euler function, trigonometric form, cos theta plus iota sine theta. Just put these values, after simplification you will get your answer. Here you can see these two questions. Integral B part, integral 0 to pi plus 2 iota cos z by 2 dz. Just simple integrate this function and just put upper and lower limits. Similarly, you can see the question number C, 1 to 3 integral z minus 2 whole raised to the power 3 dz. You should solve these two parts, then we will move forward. Okay, this is simple integration, the antiderivative, simple. Okay, just solve these two questions from exercise 4.3, part B and part C. Solve these questions.